Hello everyone. In this video, we'll discuss about important radiological concepts regarding dental cyst. Our first concept is how to differentiate a cyst and maxillary sinus flow when they are in close proximity. As you know, cyst contain fluid and maxillary sinus usually contain air. So on radiograph, maxillary sinus appears more radiolucent than cyst. Here in this panoramic CBCT image, you can see bilateral odontogenic keratocyst. This is maxillary sinus. You can easily appreciate that maxillary sinus is more radiolucent than the cyst. Then look for the cortical outline. Cortical outline of the cyst has convexity pointing upwards. However, the cortical outline of the maxillary sinus is pointing downwards. Next concept is about odontogenic keratocyst. Most of the cysts cause visible bony expansion. However, OKC can occur without any visible bony expansion. This is because OKC tends to grow in anterior-posterior direction in the medullary cavity. Also remember, OKC can cross midline like few other cysts. Next is Stafine bone defect and traumatic bone cyst position. You can remember with this image and mnemonics. Traumatic bone cyst is seen above the inferior nerve canal and Stafine bone cyst is seen below the inferior nerve canal. So here, traumatic bone cyst top of the inferior alveolar nerve canal, T for traumatic and T for top. You can also remember Stafine bone cyst in submandibular gland fossa area, like S for Stafine and S for submandibular gland fossa. One more point about traumatic bone cyst, that the radiolucent lesion shows dome-like projection which protrude between the roots of adjacent teeth. It is highly suggestive of traumatic bone cyst. Next point is pericoronal radiolucency. If the radiolucency is originating from the cement-to-enamel junction, then it is highly suggestive of dentigerous cyst. Now, how to differentiate dentigerous cyst from a dental follicle? It depends on the size of the lesion. If it is more than 5 cm, then you can consider it as dentigerous cyst. Otherwise, it could be a dental follicle only. Now, how to differentiate a radicular cyst on maxillary anterior region with another non-odontogenic cyst like incisive canal cyst and globulomaxillary cyst? First, you can check the vitality of the tooth. Radicular cyst is commonly associated with non-vital tooth. However, non-odontogenic cyst is associated with vital tooth. Radiologically, the lamina dura will be missing where the cyst is attached to the tooth. However, the lamina dura of the associated tooth will be intact in case of non-odontogenic cyst. Next point is about nasolabial cyst. Since the lesion is located within the soft tissue, no radiographic changes are expected. However, the lesion may cause depression of the bone and cause increased radiolucency of the bone in the affected region. Here in this image, you can see the depressed area of the bone. Next is incisive foramen cyst. The normal incisive foramen appears on radiograph between the two central incisors as an oval-shaped radiolucency, having the largest diameter of 6 mm. When the cyst formation takes place, it appears radiographically as a radiolucent lesion larger than 1 cm. The incisive foramen shows cortication on the sides, whereas in case of cyst, it appears rounded with cortication around the entire lesion. Next point is how to differentiate benign mucosal cyst of the maxillary sinus and fluid accumulation of the maxillary sinus. Look for the outer convexity of the lesion. In case of benign mucosal cyst, the convexity will point upward. However, it is opposite or flat in case of maxillary sinus fluid accumulation. And this is due to gravitational force. Now, if you see a young patient presents with multiple jaw cysts and there is no significant bony expansion, then think about OKC and basal cell nevus syndrome. Basal cell nevus syndrome is associated with multiple odontogenic keratocyst. Look for the other features like calcification of flax slippery, bifid ribs, and vertebral fusion. Remember, cherubism also presents with bilateral multilocular lesion, but there will be significant bony expansion as you can see in this image. Hope you find this video helpful. Comment below if you want more high yield related videos. Also, we have published a high-yield visual book on dental cyst. This book is currently available on Medina's app. You can download the app to access the book. Like this video and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Thank you.